Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to talk about ink smooching or smudging techniques. Some of these techniques you may already know or have seen before, but I also have some new techniques to share with you. And especially for this video I asked my audience to help me come up with names for these fun techniques, and I got some really great responses, some really fun and cool names, and one also a little bit scary, but that was really fun to do. So thanks everyone who joined me in coming up with the new names for the smooching techniques. So just let's go to the video and check out the fun and really cool ink smooching techniques. Now for the different techniques that I'm going to show in this video, I use a sturdy plastic, and it's from a package, I think. And this is I'm going to use different sizes of the sturdy plastic, so a really big piece and a square piece and a little rectangle piece. Then I have another piece of plastic, so really bendable plastic. And that's another plastic I'm going to use. Then I'm going to use this, and that's just a plastic foil. We call plastic wrap, I think. We call it kitchen foil, but there are lots of different names. So saran wrap, I don't know all the names. So plastic wrap of some sort. And I also use that, not only am I going to use it like this, but I also use that on my ink blending tool. So I have a regular ink blending tool with a sponge applicator on it, and I put some of the plastic wrap around it like this, and then you have another way to ink smooch or smudge. And then I have a plastic wrap, you can see it, I used it before. This is a regular dauber, and it has ink on it, but that doesn't matter because I'm going to put the plastic on it, and like with the ink blending tool, I'm going to put that around, and then I'm going to use it in that way. So let's get started with the first technique. The double decker smooch. I have the regular distress inks in three colors. I have my distress sprayer filled with water, a square piece of a sturdy acetate, and I add the ink on the acetate. And then I'm going to spray water, just a light mist to get some small drops of color, and then I flip the acetate over and press it down on my card. And I lift it and let it land again on the card to divide the ink spot a bit. I use a heat tool to dry, you can let it air dry too. And I blot with kitchen paper. I clean and dry the acetate, and then I add the next color. And I do the same, I spray some water and I turn the acetate over and press it on the card again. I also added the products I used in the description box for you. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. You can also check on my blog for detailed pictures and more information. Dry the ink again and I blot. This will add to the texture. I cleaned the acetate and then I come in with a third color, and this will give a combination of color, the blue, the pink, and a mix turns into a purplish kind of color. And this is the first technique, some basic ink smooching. Very simple and also a fast way to color a background. And this is the card I made with it, also very simple, great to have on hand for lots of occasions. The next technique is the sloppy smooch. I use distress oxide sprays for this, and I have the rectangle piece of acetate now. And I add some drops of the different colors. I dab most of the ink off in the bottle, the first drop was a bit too big, and then I make little drops by tapping on the acetate a few times with the tube from the bottle. I spray mist a bit of water and then turn the acetate over, and I put it on the card and drag it down in one movement. I put it on the card again to spread the ink a bit more, But you can leave it like it is after the first time it touched the card. I like to fill the card with ink and color. And then I dry the card and I decided I wanted a bit more of the greenish color. So I do the same and add a bit more in the corner. Dry the card again, and this is the finished card with a Tim Holtz butterfly cut out of white glitter card. The next technique is the reverse smooch. I'm going to use Distress Oxide sprays again and the big piece of acetate, and I'm going to make some handles on it with masking tape. Washi tape or regular tape will work too. It's just something to make it easier to pick up. And then I spray tiny bits of ink on the acetate with the spray bottle really close. And then I spray some water, and then I'm going to put the card on top of the acetate. And I turn the complete piece over. I press on the acetate a bit to spread the ink. You can leave it like it is too, of course. And then I'm going to lift the acetate. I let a big blob of ink drip on a piece of kitchen paper and I dab a bit from the edge. And then I blot the rest of the card. As you can see, there is some ink left on the acetate, so I add another card. And I'm going to pick up the ink that is on my desk too, just use up the gorgeous colors. And I'm going to blot again and I have another fun background. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? I share new and fun things there, like polls and behind the scenes and such. So you can check that out if you like. These are the cards I made. I kept them real simple again with some doodling and white flowers and some Nuvo drops. The next technique is the surprise smooch. I have a piece of plastic wrap on the desk and I'm going to add the Distress Oxide ink. It's similar to adding the ink to your desk, but it will add to the texture a bit as the plastic is flexible. And then I spray some water and I'm going to press on two cards. And then turn them over to see the result. And these have a bit of a tie-dye look about them. These are the cards I made with the backgrounds with the Tim Holtz wildflowers cut out of glitter card and friendship words. The next technique is the French smooch, a variation on the previous one, but more wet with the oxide sprays again. I have the plastic wrap on the desk again and the oxide ink all shaken, and now I spray them on the plastic. I spray up real close so there is hardly any mist, and I'm going to spray all the three colors. I spray water again and I'm going to press in the cards. Then I turn them over to take a look. Of course, I had to fill up the white corner by dipping in the ink again. On these cards you can see the effect of the plastic wrap better. It gives some really cool texture with no effort at all. And these are the cards I made. I cut the flower out of one card and used it on another card, and a glitter flower on the right card with the embossed heart. I'm going to use the plastic again for the folded smooch and Distress Oxide inks again. I just start making folds in the plastic, like pleats, I think they are called, like a Scottish skirt. And I do that with the complete piece of plastic. You can use other inks too, of course. I like the Distress Oxide inks. Any ink that you can clean with water will work. And when you are in doubt, just be brave and try it. And then I add the ink on top of the plastic. Just press it down, you don't want to move the folds. And I spray some water again. And now I'm going to flip the plastic over, lift it real careful, you don't want to move the folds, and then press it down on the card. And then lift it and look at the fun effect you get this way. You can do it the other way too. It's a bit easier. Just press the card in the ink and then flip the complete piece. There was lots of ink left on the plastic and it gives another fun background. And these are the cards I made, more pretty basic cards. I love doing this when I do technique cards like this, so the backgrounds really show. And now the Smooch of Doom. I changed one of the suggestions a bit. Smooch of Death was a bit too macabre, I thought. I use Distress Oxide inks again and I add the ink to a big piece of sturdy acetate. And then I'm going to spray the card on both sides against warping with the top part pretty wet. And then I press the acetate on the card ink side down. I lift the acetate and then I use the heat tool to dry from the outside in, holding the tool pretty flat. I turn the card to dry on all sides and this gives some fun texture too. And this is the finished card with some black wildflowers and foam letters for extra dimension. On with the next technique, the butterfly smooch. I love butterflies, so I had to add one. I have the flimsy acetate for this one and I add the first color ink. I spray some water and then I flip the acetate over. And I hold it at the corners and lightly touch the card, really short, like light butterfly kisses. Then I clean and dry the acetate and I dry the card with a heat tool and blot a bit. And I add the next color on the acetate and I do the same, lightly touch the card in a few spots. I dry the card and blot so the color isn't too dark. And this is the finished card with a flower cut out of glitter card and some vellum behind the sentiment. And the last one, the Precision Smooch or Gerry Smooch. So I have the Distress Oxide inks. You also need a piece of kitchen paper or cloth and a wet wipe. And the blending tool and dauber with the plastic wrap. I ink up the blending tool and spray some water and pounce on the card with the blending tool. I dry the plastic and add some more ink and repeat it, just adding some color as a base on the card. And you just want a light mist on the plastic for this. And then I'm going to use the heat tool to dry the card. And I blot to remove the leftover wet bits. And the same for the next color. I thought of this one when I first saw the ink smooching technique somewhere, and though I liked the look, I wanted a way to add the ink more precise in certain areas. Also, when using the acetate, you always get some sort of line when lifting it, because you have to bend it to lift it. And I wanted a way to get around that. Make sure you clean and dry the plastic before you ink up again. You don't want water on your ink pad. You can add more ink or pounce in the wet ink to spread it out more for a lighter or deeper color. And the same for the third color. And then I come in again with a light pink and I add more in the middle to get this powdered chalky look. And I add some more with the dauber in the same way. It's just a smaller tool for smaller spots of color. And this is the finished background. And here's the card I made with it, a butterfly from glitter card and embossed sentiment in pink, and a black one for contrast. So these are the 9 ways to create backgrounds with ink smooching. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting.